shop. This is Blaise the Mover and... Back in 2010, I made a review of Fred Claus. I haven't looked back at the review yet, but I have seen other reviews that I made that he ran. I seriously doubt this one is any different. Basically, most reviews that I made back then were fucking horrible, since they were incredibly vague, and I even made incorrect statements about movies frequently back then. And I have a feeling the same problem applies to that review. I could be fucking wrong, but I have a big feeling that's the case. The old review could possibly be good, but I fucking doubt it. So I think the best course of action is to remake that fucking review. Which I will. So without further ado, let's go! So, yeah. It's time to review Fred Claus. Except I'm doing it properly this time, unlike how I did it in 2010. But anyway, the movie is basically about what the title implies. Fred Claus, which is Santa Claus's brother. The first character that I want to talk about is of course the main character, Fred Claus, played by Vince Vaughn. Now, he's a fucking idiot, that goes without saying. But you know, I don't mind idiotic characters as long as they are funny and likable. And he is a very likable guy. Now he is a fucking idiot that can't do anything right. But his heart is in the right place. And I appreciate that about him for sure. And his jealousy for Santa Claus is completely understandable. After all, when he was a kid, no one ever fucking appreciated him and always paid attention to his brother Santa Claus. Anyone would be jealous in his situation. And because of this, there is also no wonder why he is so grumpy for a lot of the movie. He is a fucking awesome character. Now we're gonna talk about Santa Claus, played by Paul Giamatti. Now what makes Santa Claus really cool is that he's a good brother, he really is. Even when everyone else gives up on him, he's always there to fucking help him. That is so fucking awesome, that is what true brothers are for. And honestly, I do think that he is one of the best Santa Clauses in movie history. That's right, I share it. He isn't my absolute favorite, but he is one of my favorites for fucking sure. This role is fucking great. Now I'm gonna talk about Clyde Archibald Northcutt, played by Kevin Spacey. Now he is an important businessman who is threatening to shut down the North Pole. Yeah, this guy's a cunt, that goes without saying. But Kevin Spacey is really good at playing as corrupt businessman. And he does it very fucking well in this movie. This guy is selfish, as well as mean. And it fits fucking perfectly. Kevin Spacey was fucking perfect to play as this corrupt businessman. Because like I said, that's usually what he is best at in the movies he's in. Now that I'm done talking about the characters, I'm of course going to talk about other aspects of the movie. The next thing I'm going to touch on is the comedy. The comedy works very fucking well in this movie. I was laughing at a lot of fucking parts of this movie. It's mainly Fred Claus's idiots that made me laugh. But other aspects of the movie made me laugh as well. So when it comes to how funny the movie is, it really fucking is. There isn't a single joke in this movie that fell flat. Everything that was supposed to be funny in this movie fucking was. Now I want to discuss the best aspect of the movie. But I unfortunately cannot do that without spoiling the movie. So I'm going to spoiler territory for a bit now. You want to skip to my overall thoughts? Well, you will see a fucking timestamp soon. So yeah, time to go to the spoiler territory. So be prepared. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here it goes. This is a spoiler because this isn't revealed until the very fucking end of the movie. So it's literally impossible to talk about it without spoiling the fucking movie. But it is a good message, so I am talking about it. Anyway, the message is that everyone deserves a present. Now I don't agree with Fred Claus on one thing. I don't agree with him that there are no naughty children. They're all nice, but some of them have been mistreated or are misguided. I don't agree with it at all. However, there is one thing that I completely agree with him on. Everybody deserves a present on Christmas. That's right. There are some people who are plain assholes and there is no reason for it. That applies to many children as well. But even if someone is an asshole, he still deserves a present. Everyone deserves a fucking present on Christmas. That is a message that everybody should fucking keep in mind regarding Christmas. It's such a great message and a very important one. Many people need to learn it, quite frankly. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. This is one of my favorite Christmas movies of all time. It's a Christmas classic. It's wonderful, charming, funny, and has a great message. And for that, I'm of course gonna give this movie the rating 2 thumbs up. Fucking hell yeah, I watch it every Christmas and never get tired of it. You have reached the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.